Breast cancer affects millions of women worldwide. In the US, 1 in 8 women will be diagnosed with breast cancer in their lifetime. For decades, this disease has cast a long shadow over countless lives. However, medical science has made remarkable progress in treating breast cancer, significantly improving outcomes. One such advancement is the development of capivasertib. In November 2023, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration approved this drug for use with fulvestrant to treat patients with advanced hormone receptor-positive, HER2-negative breast cancer, harboring specific gene alterations. Currently, treatment options for hormone receptor-positive, HER2-negative breast cancer include hormone therapy, chemotherapy, and targeted drugs like CDK4/6 inhibitors. While these treatments can be effective, many patients develop resistance. The approval of capivasertib offers new hope for patients with limited treatment options. To understand how capivasertib fights cancer, it is essential to examine the role of AKT, also known as protein kinase B. This protein is part of the PI3K/AKT/mTOR signaling pathway, which controls cell growth and survival. Growth factor binds and activates receptor tyrosine kinase, initiating intracellular signaling. The activated receptor activates phosphoinositide 3 kinase, or PI3K. PI3K converts phosphatidylinositol bisphosphate, or PIP2, into phosphatidylinositol trisphosphate, also known as PIP3. PIP3 acts as a lipid second messenger, recruiting AKT to the cell membrane. AKT is phosphorylated, leading to its full activation. Activated AKT phosphorylates various downstream targets, including mTOR, thus stimulating protein synthesis and cell growth. In many cancers, including breast cancer, genetic mutations cause this pathway to be overactive, fueling tumor growth. Capivasertib works by inhibiting AKT, disrupting this abnormal signaling, and hindering cancer cells from growing and spreading. The approval of capivasertib was based on findings from the Phase 3 CAPItello-291 trial, involving 708 patients with locally advanced or metastatic hormone receptor-positive or HER2-negative breast cancer, including 289 patients whose tumors had AKT pathway alterations. This study compared patients receiving oral capivasertib with intramuscular fulvestrant, an estrogen receptor antagonist, to those receiving a placebo with fulvestrant. People who took capivasertib, along with fulvestrant, lived without their cancer getting worse for a significantly longer time compared to those who took a placebo. This was true for all patients, including those with AKT pathway altered tumors. On average, patients receiving capivasertib had a median progression-free survival of approximately 7 months as compared to 3 to 4 months among those receiving placebo. Additionally, overall survival rates at 18 months were higher in the capivasertib plus fulvestrant group, in the overall population, as well as patients with AKT pathway altered tumors. The most frequent grade 3 or higher adverse events with capivasertib and fulvestrant were rash and diarrhea. Ongoing research will continue to expand our understanding of capivasertib and its potential combinations with other therapies. The future of breast cancer treatment is undoubtedly promising. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.